Good morning, and welcome to another exciting episode of DDOwiki Talk with your host, ShoeMaker. How is everybody this morning? Good morning, Lessa. Looks like there's been a little bit of a discussion about having soda with your cereal instead of milk. I don't know, back in my day we used to use orange juice instead of milk, but I guess if you want to use soda, it's about the same. Let me get a little bit of background music going before I bring up the wiki. You did! But I'm not giving anything away today. Well, maybe an invisible stalker. Oh, there we go. I can hear some stuff now. I don't know. We used to do orange juice back in my day. That was the thing. Orange juice with your cereal. All right, let's bring the wiki up and let's show you guys the wiki. There we go. Here we are. So here's our homepage. We've decided that we're going to start putting Lamania preview stuff in the What's New table. Figured it was appropriate, but that it should be properly indicated that that is Lamania. All the regular updates will have this pink color. Lamania will have the Lamania grayish blue color, and we'll say Lamania preview. My anniversary blob has been slid down the page a little bit and collapsed, so you'll have to show it if you want to read it. Sitemap, well, we haven't done much with that. Much of the other stuff there. Let's take a look at recent changes real quick. You notice the highlight I posted in the discussion part of the Whirling Blades. You know what, Titan? That was an extremely funny thing that happened. I'm glad that you mentioned it, or I might have forgotten about it. We'll get to that when I get up to that part of the recent changes. So we got some files got moved, and they got redirected file tagged to them, so we can find them later to clear out any backlinks and delete them properly. Lots of talks. I did some changes with Cobalt Sneak, and my regex expression that I used was a little bit lenient, and I had to go back and clean up after it. It's one of the things that happens sometimes. JJ did some stuff. Sue added some tabs to their page. Let's see here. A lot of categorization changes. Template developer is something that I've been working on this week. Makes it a little bit easier to mention developers. Some category work, trying to clean out some wanted categories. She will shortly enough. The I blocked an account that was never a nanny bot. Because it has the word bot in the name, it's not an acceptable username unless the person gets in touch with an administrator. And we have a little bit of discussion about what the bot is supposed to do, if it's supposed to even be a bot account. If it's not supposed to be a bot account, then we might need to do a little bit of a rename to clarify that it is not a bot. So get in touch with me if that was your account that I blocked because it was an unacceptable username. And we will figure out how to make it so that you can edit. Let's see here. DDOwiki talk, administrator's notice board. That was something I was talking about there. Gadget definition. Which reminds me, I gotta do some work on that. But that'll be after the stream. Let's see here. Account comparisons. There was a talk, some talk on the forums about that. There was a thread. Is VIP worth it? I think that it is. It's certainly a valuable investment. If you can afford it, if you can't, you should be watching this show so that you can get premium free-to-play if you don't already have it. Because you never know which week I might give out a starter pack. And a starter pack will make your account premium. Let's see here. Sue did some work on the augment template. Scroll through here quickly. I don't want to spend too much time on recent changes today. A lot of augment stuff. Developer. Tide turns. Naming policy. I did some trimming there to reflect a couple of changes of the software, as such as the threshold is now 300k instead of 150 for what's considered a large file. Yeah, you have been bored, haven't you, Sue? Oh, let's see here. That's good. I like it. I've been doing a lot of developer work. Trying to work on their pages a little bit. Talk, Whirling Blades. Something we wanted to look at. Media Wiki Talk, Gadget Spam. Move that over. Alright, and I think that wraps up our recent changes, other than these two right here, which are something that I was working on this morning to just figure out what I was going to do for this show. Let's see here. It wasn't half of the party, it was only a third. Sure, you could have put it on the Potion of Wonder page as well, I suppose. But talk page was certainly a more appropriate place for it than on a page itself. Good work going for the talk page. That's where those types of things belong, on talk pages. So we have this template developer, where the goal is, when you're quoting a developer from the forum, it was becoming frustrating to me to remember which developers have wiki accounts, to remember which developers and producers are no longer employees, and to remember how to get to the forum page for the developer. So, I started working on a template that's just developer, and then the developer name. And if you use that template, so if Corden says something silly, and you post it on the wiki as a forum quote, you can just use as source developer Cordovan. And it will automatically put in Cordovan's wiki link, his contributions, message, email, because apparently he's put in an email if you have that gadget enabled and you have your email in, and then a link to his forum. The email might go away. He might decide to, you know, disable emailing. Currently he has it enabled, so I guess it's fair game, but he may decide to disable email if he gets too much junk. So don't send him a bunch of junk. That would be bad. Or you could do Aladrin, and you got former developer Aladrin, and links to his page. All kinds of them here. If you want to see a list of which pages link to which developer, there's this meta category pages linking to a Turbine employee. Some of them are former employees. So that category page name might change. I really don't like pages mentioning a turbine employee. But I don't know, I can't think of anything better to put in there. So I'm going to leave it as that for now. Oh yeah, we got some people showing up. I guess I will do a giveaway this week. Let's see here. Computer. UMA. Last semester, CIS 312, turbine code giveaway. Fire that up real quick. Turbine, well, they're not employees anymore, some of them. So it was mentioning a turbine employee part that wasn't clicking with me, because they're not all employees. All right, so let's start this application up. Shrink this down. Now, remove that. Let's add a source for that. Grab that here, stick that in there, make this a little bigger so you guys can see it. Alrighty, so I am going to do an invisible mini stalker today. I want 12 people today. I think that's where I'm going to go. Let's see here. We had Titan. We had Lessa. We have Susalona. We have Z332. We have Isander. We have Amaref. So that's what we're up to so far. We're halfway there. Let's save this week and shrink that down for now. Alrighty. So yeah, in order to see which pages each developer linked to, if you come to this page here, the name in the developer list here is a link to their individual categories. So developer link to category, format in the list above. For developers that use a template that aren't on this list yet, so if you use Purple Foos, for example, who isn't on this list yet, it will show up pages with an unknown game developer link, which should have none in it at the moment, which is correct. And actually, I'm going to edit that real quick, because I don't want to have to navigate to see how many are in there each time. So I am going to do PIC, if I remember correctly. I'm going off memory here. It's been a long time since I've used this. It might even be PIC. Let's see how this works. No. Capital I. PIC for pages in category. Ah, there it is. So zero. There are no pages in that category. Well, you're always the first one here, Titan. I always add people in the order that I see them in the list of people in the DDO stream chat box. So the first name I see is Titan, then Lessa. Scrolling down, then Sue, then Z, then Xander, then Amareth, and now Edward. So let's add Eddie. There we go. And actually, I'm going to add counts for each one of those as well. We'll do that fairly quickly if we can. Actually, I could do this too. Let's stretch this out a little bit. I don't like it when it wraps on me. There we go. Sometimes I don't like word wrap. Which reminds me, I should make an option on the wiki that will allow you to disable wrapping in that text box. That might take me some work, though. So I learned last week that one of the game developers, who's probably working not on DDO at the moment, he bounces back and forth a little bit. Siloran here is actually semi-related to me. Turns out he's my oldest daughter's aunt's fiance. I thought that was kind of cool that one of my children is gonna have Uncle Silurin. I also found something out about Steel Star this week, actually just yesterday, but I'm afraid that I can't share that at the moment. Because I don't know if that's public knowledge yet. So that's going to be one of those little secrets that I'm going to have to hang on to for a little while. Until I know that he's already said it's okay for people to know. So yeah, now we got counts for each one of them. I'm going to edit that again. I want a little bit of space in there. What does that look like? I think tab just adds a bunch of spaces, not a universal tab stop. I might have to do some work to the pages and category template to make it so that it's not quite so pushy size-wise. I see some of them are in red, and are you aware of that secret, Titan? Do you know about Steel Star's special thing? Okay. Then I'm gonna hang on to that one for a little bit. Alright, so puts a little space in there. You know what? I don't like it. Chop it all out. Open up Notepad. Paste. Replace this with space slash T. I want extended, not regular expression. Replace all. Close. Let's actually turn off word wrap. Tab, 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 tab. Now these tabs that I'm manually adding. Oh. You know what? I'm being silly. I shouldn't be doing this as a list if I want this type of formatting. That is something that I do for coding. One of our coding conventions for JavaScript and CSS, be that it not exceed a certain number of characters per line. And that blue area is where it exceeds that number of characters per line. But I'm not working on JavaScript at the moment, so I don't really care about that blue shaded area. Now, if I want to do this correctly, I want to align this to the right. All right, I I can turn word wrap back on. Align that to the right. That's already aligned to the left. And that's aligned to the left, that's fine. Chop all that out. Dump this. Paste this. Take a quick look. I do have a double there because I did the search replace thing. I can live with that, I guess. Alrighty. Yeah, it's just a minor thing. I'm not going to spend too much time on it. So, let's get those pages loaded. I have this despammer gadget where I mentioned to the other developers, the other administrators, that I wrote a new gadget that will block a spam-only account and delete rollback all contributions automatically right from the recent changes page, new account line. Is now in the gadgets test phase section, but you can only see it if you have block, delete, and rollback permissions. So if you don't have those permissions, you can't see the gadget on your gadgets page. But it is a good gadget for administrators to two click, and quickly eliminate a spam account. It has a known issues list. It is not very pretty. It has no configurable options yet. It just does what I told it to do. It has no interface. There's not much you can see about what's happening. It just does it. And the status notification that kind of tells you what it's doing in the corner is poor at best. It is also In order to use it, it's also dependent on the group changes by page and recent changes and watch list option being enabled. I plan on working on fixing that issue soon. Maybe this afternoon or tonight or something. I don't know yet. It's on my to-do list. It might not happen until this next weekend. Who knows? But it is on my list of things to do. I am aware of it. So, the thing Titan wanted to talk about.
Well, put bleed on my
All right, so we're gonna do, we're gonna go full stream here. We don't really care about what's in the talk section over here. Oh, but then again, it does hide a bunch of people behind the talk list there. Let's hide my Twitch chat for a second. There we go. Now you can see what's going on. Are you ready? I don't know if you can hear it or not, but I click Potions of Wonder and we get a blade spawn there. And you can see the people falling off the page. Where'd those blades come from? I don't remember there being blades in there before either.
Potion of Wonder for the win!
I did, it was awesome. As you can see, I was just like cracking up laughing. I thought it was hilarious. This is up on YouTube. You can watch it as many times as you want. That was nice enough. I took him to the shrine, Not an evil person. D ink. We love D ink. And that was that. So, will the blades hurt that troll? No, I don't think so. I don't know. I don't know what that troll is, but now we got LSD working this on Deep Gnome this morning. Alrighty, so what were we gonna work on today? Oh yes, unused templates. So we head over to special pages. Let's take a look here. It takes a little minute to load up here. Just the other day, I worked on the script that adds those numbers. And I added wanted pages back to the list. The other ones, like uncategorized files and list of redirects and things like that, those all have numbers too. But the numbers are larger than 5,000, so I have opted to turn them off for now because they would take a long time to load. If it was a pet troll somebody had summoned, yes, it would hurt the troll. So I wanted to work on this 267 unused templates today. We've got things like three tilds and five tilds. And it's protected, and that's protected. For the record, there is also a four tilts. And that one's not protected. Go figure. The one that needs to be protected the most, because it's the most used, is the one that isn't protected. Right, so let's bring these up in a Firefox logged into my account. And shrink that down so I can see what's going on. Alright. So we're going to edit the page. No include, include only. Ugh. Oh, that's not right. That's broken. I'm glad nobody uses it. It's been broken for a long time, apparently. What does 4Till's source code look like? That's what 4 looks like. That's what it should look like. And that one's broken. Alrighty. So, what I'm going to do is copy 4 into 5. I'm going to delete one of those, delete one of those. Add one of those with another tilde in it. Oh, this is 5, so I need 2, 1, and 2. All right, so that's 5. Good morning, your demon lover. I have that right? Signature only. This is 3, so I don't need that. This is 4, so I don't need that. You're a new face. Added. All fixed. So I got 3 tilds, 4 tilds, 5 tilds. Cool. I like the way that works. 3 tilds is done. 4 is 5 is done. We need to protect 4. Administrators only. Confirm. Alrighty. So we're done with that. Those are all updated. So 3, 4, and 5 are done. If we refresh the page here, you'll see 3 and 5 disappear. Going down. Absolute law. I'm not gonna touch that one right now. It's actually a deprecated template. Accuracy. Okay, so this one right here is something that is only used on interface messages. So we're gonna include only that. We're gonna no include. Coding. Usage. Used on interface pages to offer links for I can never spell bureaucrats. I love spell check because I can never spell it. I don't know which ones of those exist, if either. Alright, so... copy this. There we go. I like it. Alrighty. Another one goes from the list, 264. This whole series of templates needs to be cleaned up at some point. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight row. Oh, good Lord. Let's just do that. It's inconsistent. I can't have that. 4, 5, 6. Move. Let's put a slash in there. Put a slash in there. Put a slash in there. Moved. 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 I don't know what half of these parameters mean. What a mess this is. That's what I think of that. Take a look at row. So the T is the time, the OID is the old ID. So that's what those parameters mean. I still think it's ugly and it needs to be completely dumped and redone. But it is what it is for now, and I don't want to spend a lot of time on it. It's almost time for our break. Almost. Alright. Now I need to go to this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. And edit, 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 edit. And paste. Paste, 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 back around. I need to have that in there twice. Save, paste, save, paste, Save. Paste. Save. Paste. Saved. And now the emails start showing up. Apparently I had that watch list. Alrighty. I'm gonna get a few emails. Alright, so that should take out five of those. 264 to 259. 265. Why did I go up? Oh, because I'm not actually using it. I'm just linking to it. I'm gonna make this little span here. Style. Display. None. Because I don't want to copy and paste that to all the pages, and I'm going to be dumping it eventually anyways. Those aren't supposed to show up. Span, style, display, none. So it wraps it differently. What can I do to make that not show up? Who did it originally? Oh, I don't know. Let's find out. Probably one of the old people. And old people, I mean founders of the wiki. It's something that's been around forever. Let's see here. Elliot Cable. He didn't do it wrong. It's just that when he did it back in 2006, the wiki software was vastly different than it is now. So the things that he did that were correct back then have been phased out, deprecated, modified, adjusted, and it is no longer even close to being something that's feasible or useful. If I change that to div. One, two, three, four, five, six. There we go, that'll work. Okay. All right, so let's go to row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm actually going to delete all of these templates before long. Because I'm just going to put it into a loop, a looping structure, which we now have access to. Because we didn't have that before, it was done the old-fashioned way. There we go. Now those five are gone. All right, so coffee break, and then we'll go back to working on some more of these. I know these ones can be taken care of. All All right, break time. And we're back with a fresh cup of coffee. All right, so we got 8 of 12 people so far for our giveaway. I needed to work on that too. All right, a lot of these, why is Archives Row still showing up? Oh. Okay. That one didn't get documented. Oh, because it's got a capital R. Okay. Oh, goody, goody, goody. That's how messed up it is. These ones we can take care of. Current day of year, 54. Seems about legit. Good morning, Peter. Nope, that shouldn't be no included, that should be include only. Current 2nd of the minute All right, that's right. I forgot to do that. Who is texting me? My girlfriend that's complaining that I'm not spending enough time talking to her when she knows that I'm kind of busy doing my show. But she complains about anything. I could be texting her and she'd be texting me that she's complaining that I'm not texting her enough while I'm texting her. It is what it is. I still love her. God save me, but, you know. Alright, so documentation, save, documentation, save, fix, documentation. That too. Good morning, Trickster. You like being part of lists. Lists that give prizes, right? Oh. Maybe Titan. Alright, so if I refresh the page, these numbers should change the top two. Good. Oh, I did. I forgot to put the chat window back up. Oh, nobody wants to see the chat window anyways, right? There it is. Pick me, pick me. Alrighty. I can add you to the list for show. You make number 11. We need one more viewer. in order to be able to draw that. Alright, bold. Oh, I don't know what bold is. It just makes bold text. Yeah, we could, I don't know when, but I can certainly do an abbot sometime. That reminds me. I don't know what this template is. I'm actually gonna request this be deleted. Alright, so, and I made sure to wrap that in no includes, because that doesn't need to be included if it was to be used anywhere, which it's an unused template, so that's not an issue anyway. Alright, let's see here. Mod. Tenth anniversary stuff. Oh, those all could be probably deleted. A lot of those unused could be deleted. Titan, you are a young man. I am glad you have such high aspirations and such big dreams. That said, keep dreaming big, bub. I've been dating for, I don't know, 25 years now? For as long as you've been alive. And I have never, ever found any kind of balance like that, so... If you find it, great. Keep dreaming big. So, as part of the 10th anniversary event, it's been released on Lanania. That there'll be a list of freebie items that you can pick one of. On this list, from Abbott, you can get a quiver, a litany, a staff, or an unwavering ardency. Don Pope, huh? I don't know, that kind of seems like a sock to me. But I'll give it the benefit of the bout, of the doubt. And that gives us 12. As something I've been working on trying to get it done before. Before update 30 hits live, is I'm trying to make a table here that shows the difficulty to acquire each of the freebies and what is required. So, for example, to get a quiver of alacrity, you need to it's min level 1. It's an ascension chamber. I'm gonna bump that up to very hard, actually. It requires access to the Necropolis Part 4. And it requires an average of 40 runs of Ascension Chamber, which requires flagging by completing 4 runs, one for each path of Litany of the Dead, which requires flagging by completing a single frame, which is most quickly done by completing an average of 3 runs of each of Temple of All, Fleshmaker's Lab, Inferno, and Ghost of Perdition. So it's 12, 16, about 60 quest runs in order to get a quiver of alacrity. When I say average of 40, that doesn't mean that you'll get it in 40 runs. I've heard of people not getting it in 120 runs on the 20th list. But I've also heard of a lot more people getting it in the first 20 lists. So it's an average. You could get it in 20 runs. You could get it in 60 or 80 runs, or you could get it in 200 runs. But the above 60 is kind of outliers. And then there are people that get it in 1 to 20 runs because they just get that lucky. I hate those people. What's up with that? I mean, come on now. Does it count for all time completions? No, it's counting 20th lists. Maybe I should change the wording to that. So it's 20th list, so it's runs per life. Caught in the web stuff is very easy to get. You just open up a Raider reward box and pull it out. And everybody got one or two Raider reward boxes at one time, so I really don't consider caught in the web stuff hard to get. Yeah, I got 16 people in my list as well. I like the quiver. It's nice. ShoeMaker has one. It's the only tune I have that I've actually run enough to get one. But anyways, this table right here, I'm kind of burnt out on it at the moment. I worked on it for hours and hours and hours yesterday. So if somebody else wanted to pick up where I left off and fill in the requirements of acquiring one, or if they wanted to have some discussion or change the difficulty to acquire, by all means, go ahead and update that. And I would like to see it get done by the end of the week. I don't know that I'll have time to work on it, so it probably won't happen because I know a lot of people are afraid of editing things like that. If you break it, I will fix it. So don't worry about breaking it. There's this little thing that if you break it, all you gotta do is go to page history and say, show me the edit that I just did that broke it and undo it. Not hard to do. Let's take a look at recent changes, see if anybody's been working on it. Air Dweller was easy to get. It drops in like 8 different quests. You get it less than 20 runs usually. I don't have a tune that I don't get it. I don't think it's a very useful item anymore, really. Ever since they did the effect pass around Shadowfell, or maybe it was even Venice, I don't remember. They did a pass, and they changed the effects, and I didn't like the way that it changed. Alright, so let's see here. Yeah, ever since they changed 100% spell damage to a tiny amount of spell power or something like that, I haven't been all that keen on it. Let's go back here. I had these marked as easy because all you gotta do is open a Raider's reward box, but somebody changed them, so I'm going to leave it for discussion. It drops, so the Ear Dweller drops an Eye of the Titan, I Dream of Jeets, Finding the Path, and Dreaming Dark. It also, if I remember correctly, doesn't it show up occasionally on the three completion end reward list? No, maybe not. Maybe that's just the Ion Stones. Which I'm surprised those aren't on the freebie list. So it's an old description. It still says 100% bonus of spell damage. So it's actually plus 25 psionic bonus of spell power. It was update 14 that they changed it. Okay, it's not hard to farm. So they went from 100% spell damage, 100 spell power, to 25 psionic bonus. It's like, really? So you're cutting its effectiveness by 75%? Very sad. It was a very sad day indeed. I suppose the lava is cool. Gives you some spell points. But, you know, I'm not here to dev bash. I just think that that was a bad choice to go from 100 spell power to 25 like that. Alright, so special pages. What else is there? Let's take a look. We've done enough unused templates for now. A lot of those I need to go through on my admin account and actually just delete because they're junk. I suppose I'm going to have to put up discussions about each one of them, but, you know. Uncategorized pages. Where's one? Ooh, wanted categories. 31. Uncategorized pages. Let's see here. Wanted categories. Anything here of any use? I don't know what's going on with all these spell. It's a template change that somebody made, and they haven't come back to fix the category structure. So I believe, if I remember correctly, I had it set for clicky items and then whatever the clicky effect is. Like these ones. But somebody changed it, and I don't know what's going on, because there's still some clicky item ones, and then there's these spell ones, and I don't know what's what here. I'll also mention Sue, your augment thing has a whole bunch of unknown color, unknown rarity, categories that need to be populated if you're going to go with that route. I really don't care what the category structure is for that. I'm glad somebody's expanding it a little bit. Min level 49 augments. Guessing that's a bug. Augment test case. Ah, it's a test case. You're welcome. Yep. Not a bug. You're welcome. Just a test case. This augment is bugged, but slated to be fixed in update 50. Sounds about right. So apparently my girlfriend's cat is looking at her strangely, sitting on her lap, which is unusual for him. And she said, he looks different to me. And I said, he thinks you look different. And she said, he looks grumpy and ready to fight. And I said, maybe you stepped on him going pee at 3 a.m. and he's waiting for his chance at revenge. Who knows? You know, pregnant women go and pee at 3 a.m. Maybe she stepped on his tail and it irked him the wrong way, and now he's waiting for his revenge. Ha ha ha, I'm going to get you. Adorable indeed. Marion probably roughed him up. Yeah, probably. My 4-year-old does that. So what do you mean by no value? Okay, so it's working now. Okay. Alright, so we got this one down here. I mean, if the field is left blank, a default value is supposed to show, but it isn't. So this is on same thing for weight. So if weight is empty, but I see a default value of 0.01 pounds. So okay, so that's working now. What other issues are you having with the template? Anything that I can help you work on live stream in the last 15 minutes here? Working. Categorization. Working. So it looks like you got everything working. It's just that you want to change your augments by color. So if everything is working, that is awesome. Okay. Then it is time to move that template to technically it should be named augment, even though yeah, it should be named augment. They're all named augments. So a template should be moved from your test case page to named augment. To get it right, the anniversary token is for everyone working in the same way. I have no idea. I haven't done anniversary token. They're not all named. Which one isn't named? These are named. The name is Ruby Eye of Erosion, Ruby Eye of Inferno, Ruby Eye of the Glacier. Those are the names. Meteoric Star Ruby, that is the name. That is the name. Its name is Yep, those are the names. Ruby Eye of Righteousness is the name. Plus the purchasables. The generic ones? We don't have pages for the generic ones, do we? Because I don't think that we need pages for all of the ability plus one, ability plus two, ability plus three, ability plus four. I don't think we need pages for those augments. That's a lot of extra pages, and I don't think there's need for them. They're generic. We don't have pages for every possible combination of random loot. Why would we have pages for every possible combination of augments? I think that's overkill. That should be on a list of... It's already easy to find. Where is it? Oh. Purchasable augments. This is where you go to find where to buy augments. This is how it should be. A list of vendors and a list of what they sell at each vendor. I think this is the best way to do that, where to find. I really don't want to see this turn into a big wall of blue with all of these different augments. That's a lot of augments. We should have a discussion on Wiki about it. Can you start one, please? Maybe on the administrator's notice board? Thank you. Those pages are not categorized. Why is this down here twice? Why do I have a picture for 8? Oh, those are the member pages. I gotta figure out how I want to categorize those later. So it's a... All right, so this should be marked as a bug. Oh, that reminds me. Got a couple minutes left. There was recently a discussion on the forums about the known issues list. Cordovan and the developer team, as I understand it, would like to mostly get rid of that list. It's not something that is readily maintainable. They're just so busy working on trying to fix the bugs and creating new content and whatnot that they really don't have time to maintain a list. And Cordovan has been hesitant to remove it, because he knows that a lot of people like to look at it. What my question is, what is the community's... Remove the list itself. Fixing the bugs on them. Some of them are just things that'll never be fixed because of reasons. What my question is, which will answer Cordovan's question, is what would be the community interest in doing a community maintained bug list on the wiki or the forums? Cordovan would be happy to start a thread or a forum category on bugs. I think it would be much more up-to-date and maintainable if the players maintained a list than the developers trying to maintain a list. We actually have... some stuff. Well, if it's a forum thread, then the developers could respond to the thread just like anybody else. So, You know, they could say, hey, that's working as intended, that's not a bug. The developers could still very well be involved. It would be forum-based instead of a non-interactable list that they have to maintain. Nope, and that's fine. We don't have to agree. As long as it's the issues there for them to know about, then, and as long as the interaction is there so that other people that come across it can see it, and then, you know, the big thing is if there was a forum section on that, hey, Queen. If there was a forum section on that, it would have to be something that it would be much more up to date. It would be very, very much more current. If it was forum based, it would have to be something where they were respectful and appropriate adult discussions. If you're trying to argue with the devs and convince them or force them to see your point of view, the thread would just be shut down. So if it's something where you're explaining how to do an exploit on the forums, the thread would be shut down, and you'd probably get warned for it, because that's not something that's allowed. The same thing is if the thread was on the wiki. We actually have a category for game bugs. Unofficial known issues, which nobody really maintains anymore, could come back to life. We have a section for bugs that have been fixed recently but not mentioned in any release notes. I think if the official known issues list was to go away, then these things would be much more updated by people. We also have the category itself, which lists pages that have some kind of bug. I could very easily make a template for the wiki that would make it so that you can enter an entry. You can put the date where the bug was first noticed. We could put a description of the bug. And then I could have one for a date of last verified that the bug still exists. And then I could add one for fixed, when the bug was fixed, so that it would cross that item out and then disappear after a fixed amount of time. I think that would be much more efficient to have all of the players updating such an unofficial list on the wiki or on the forums than the official known issues list ever could possibly be. I mean, so if you have any thoughts on that, get in touch with Cordovan and let him know what you think about the official known issues list. Alrighty, so it's 10 o'clock. It is time to do our drawing. I still have invisible mini stalkers on Caneth, Wayfinder, and one other server that I don't remember which one. I want to say maybe Kyber. If you don't happen to be on one of those servers, I will get in touch with Cordovan and have him send you an invisible mini stalker, or have him send me some on that server, so that I can get you your prize. Your disappointment with Uska making it to the council. I don't know what that's all about, but anyways, let's do our roll for winner. Crazy Trickster. Donuts? Where's the donuts? So leave that up there until we finish the stream here. We're gonna go back to DDOwiki here. I love donuts. Donuts are my friend. Sorry, Peter, there's no donuts left. I already ate them all. Okay, so great. You're on a server that I have certificates on. Excellent. Donuts are fattening. You want to see what the results of donuts are? That's the results of donuts. Anyway, so I will get you your prize in a few minutes. It is 10:03 now, so I need to sign off. Everybody have a great week. I am hoping and expecting to be home next Sunday for Shoe Cobbles A, and I believe that it's a Drow Rogue week. It is beautiful, isn't it? It's a beautiful thing. I look pregnant. Then again, I kind of am pregnant, because when your girlfriend is pregnant, that makes you pregnant too. It's some weird pregnancy thing. So everybody have a great week. And hopefully I'll see you on Sunday. If not, I will be back next week for DDOwiki Talk episode 22, I believe. I think this is episode 21. Have a great week. Bye, everyone.